Oh, I can't do that, no, lovely. I'm not used to people being in the studio, sorry, my line.
So, hi, Altrincham.
Good evening, Altrincham.
As you can see, Chris is buzzing a little bit tonight. What has got into you tonight? What's going on, Chris?
I'm just happy.
What's been happening in your life, then? Oh, we've got photographers in.
Yes.
Oh my lord, what's happened? Yeah, we've got company in the studio tonight, but a little more on that coming up in the next few minutes.
Oh, that's exciting.
As they say in TV world. So, hi folks, how are you doing? Thanks for joining us tonight. Camera's a little bit crooked tonight, Chris, is it not?
Oh, okay, who gives
it? It looks as though I'm going to slide off the end of the picture.
Oh, that's a good thing, actually, because it's my show after all.
So, folks, thanks for joining us. If you'd like to join in, please do in the comments right below this video.
Sorry, you're making me laugh.
Join in the comments right below this video, or I'm not prepared here, am I? Let me just see if I've got my equipment with me.
Well, don't be getting it out on camera, love.
Right, I have my equipment with me. So, yes, you can call as well on 07 874 055 6. Shall I write that down for you?
No, it's alright, Andy. Just jump off the settee while you can.
07 874 055 611. If you'd like to call in and have a chat, tell us what you think about what's going on in Altrincham, what we're up to, and...
While you're there, Joe, do you want to actually just sort the camera out, sorry?
Alright, a little bit of technical stuff going on here.
It's just making me laugh.
Yeah, well, my own, a few seconds, but... Oh, look, there we go.
Yeah.
Right, there. Now, that's how you do it.
Yeah.
Producer Joe has nailed it there, so...
Thanks, Joe. So a lot of things have been going on around Altrincham News, haven't they, for the last week?
Yeah, somebody's just commented, the football team are doing well. We've started posting updates from Altrincham Football Club, because we know there's a big following.
Yes, quite a bit.
Especially now, apparently they're at the top of a league table for the first time since
2013.
Oh, check Chris out on the ball there. So yeah, Alti are doing well, aren't they? So we'll keep an eye on the Altrincham Football Club news for you, because you seem to like it, and whatever you like, we endeavour to provide.
Yeah.
Is that not the case? So what else is happening, Chris?
What's happening? We've just been very busy.
We have. We've got a lot coming up, haven't we?
Yeah, we've got to get our calendars out, Andy.
We have, apparently, because we're having a lot of new events being fed in to proceedings.
Yes, quite a lot, thanks.
Well, some fresh new ideas that are coming into the team.
Yes.
And we both know where this is leading, don't we? Because, yeah, tonight we actually have somebody to introduce to you.
Dun, dun, dun.
Which is a brand new team member of Altrincham News. And don't worry, you'll get used to this one quite well.
And, oh, you'll love her.
I introduce our new member, Kat.
Hi.
Kate, come on, Kat.
Commentators, Kate.
Okay.
Put your
head up. Yay! Well, look at that.
Like, hi, Altrincham.
What a beauty. This is our new team member.
Hi.
Welcome along, Kate. How are you?
Thank you. I'm really well, thank you. Very happy to be here with the boys. Sorry, that was me laughing before, because until you're in the studio, you don't actually realise how funny you actually both are. So, yeah, they've had me in stitches, actually, since I've been here. So, yeah, I've got to say I'm really happy to be here, and I'm happy to be on board.
Yes.
So, there you go.
So now you've got to get used to her.
Be kind.
Yes, please. Otherwise you get me involved in that.
Stephen Hickman woohooing at you, Chris.
Oh, hi Steve, woohoo. Hope you enjoyed the green room.
Jamie Pinkerton would like a shout out.
Woohoo!
I've just seen it, Sue Breen. Saying hi to you.
Hi Sue, thanks for tuning in. Whoa. I know Sue.
Oh, good. Oh.
She's one of my ballet students.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she's a very lovely lady, actually. So, hi, Sue. Thanks for tuning in tonight. Nice bit of support.
Yeah, carry on. She shared the videos to your friend that Kate's here with us.
So, yeah, guys, thanks for joining us. So, are you a local girl, Kate?
I work in Bowdoin. So I'm not quite local, I kind of live in the surrounding areas, about 7 minutes away. I work in Bowdoin, I'm not going to say where I work, but I am a manager of a centre over there, and I co-run the local ballet school in Bowdoin as well, so that's how I know Sue from the adult ballet classes that we run. But yeah, I know a lot about the area. I love Altrincham, I've grown up here, I was a Loretto girl at one point for my sins, so yeah, I'm a resident to Altrincham, basically, in theory.
Jamie Pinkerton is asking, where's his shout out? I think he actually wanted a name check off you, Chris.
Oh, hi, Jay.
Well, that do you, Jamie?
Unless you want a woohoo.
Woohoo!
There you go, that's what you're getting. Oh, you love that, don't you?
Do you know what? I really like, can I have one?
Yeah. Go on then, Chris.
No, I want you to woohoo me. I would never dare do the woohoo.
Is it beneath you?
No, I just don't think I could do it.
Say hi. Okay, I've got one. Here we go. Say hi.
Oh, it's all going horribly wrong already.
It's going great. This is pretty good. It's so good to be here.
It's good to be in the middle.
Excuse me? No. That's the opportunity for one of my certificates of the tower.
Well, you're not allowed to say that.
I just can't get that out of my head. I set myself up for that all the time, don't I? It's just wrong! Completely.
I was taking my scarf off.
In there now, yeah. Right?
Good, we like that.
Make yourself at home.
I am, yeah, I need some fruit.
Come on, Joe. Right.
Producer stroke tea lady. Oh, Jamie, you've not just had a KFC, have you?
Oh, God, not from Altrincham, dude.
I'm not going to say any more on that, but I've always had issues with that place.
Yeah, Altrincham KFC.
I've been advised not to say so much about it.
I did have a Nando's. That was nice.
I've not been to Nando's yet.
Do you know what? It's really, really nice. Go, try it. Better than the KFC.
Yeah, I'm more of a McDonald's sort of guy. I love my cheeseburgers.
I like the coffee from there. They do good coffee.
Or McDonald's they do, yeah.
I know, really good coffee.
And you were telling us about Bistro Pierre before, and all. You're a fan of that, are you?
Do you know, I went for dinner at Bistro Pierre. I can't say it. Pierre before. It was really good. Really lovely. I mean, we had the two-course menu. So it was about £15 for two of us, me and Mr. B. And yeah, delicious food. So, yeah. Shout out to Bistro Pierre. We enjoyed it. We will be back. Actually, we went to Sugo as well, which was that's near the Altrincham Market. Fantastic food.
Corner, yeah.
They are changing their menu soon as well, around Halloween. So if you haven't tried Sugo, go to Sugo and just try the pasta. I know it's only pasta, but this is seriously good ingredients. They get it imported all the way from Italy. Beautiful. So I can't wait to go and try it again when the new menu changes. Really nice food.
That looks like we've got to have a night out.
It sounds like it, doesn't it?
Definitely.
Yeah, Kate Jill Madden is now saying hello to you. You've got quite a following already.
I've got a following.
You've only been here 10 minutes.
Hi Jill, shout out.
Is this another one of your ballet students?
Alright, I'm going to come clean, that's my auntie.
Everybody's got an auntie.
Hi
Jill.
Auntie, can I just say happy birthday, Auntie Jill, as well? It was a birthday yesterday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Shall we?
Happy birthday, Auntie Jill. Love you.
Shall we? We did it last time.
Happy birthday to you.
Woo!
Happy birthday to you.
Woo!
Happy birthday, Auntie Jill.
Woo!
Auntie Jill, you need to be here. This is great.
Ironically, Tracy Hall says that you just can't take this seriously. Well, we don't really take ourselves 100% seriously.
You can't take yourself seriously. Why are you not? You're not on this sofa then, are you?
I've got to say, Tracy, if you came in, you would have a brilliant laugh. It's actually quite serious, to be honest, when we're having a team meeting, discussing everything. But, yeah, give it a chance.
Hey guys, who's the addition? Hi Mandy! That's Mandy. Mandy, Miss Say hello to Kate.
Hi, Mandy.
New member of the team will be... I don't know when you'll be joining us. You're welcome to join us anytime. But,
Anytime, you're
finding your feet with us at the moment, aren't you?
I need to find that out. I've been doing a lot of digging around for stories and interviews and all sorts of things. So, yeah. I'll tell you what I've got soon, but...
Hi, Karen.
I was looking for you this morning outside the Weatherspoon, like last Sunday morning. She looked rent. She wasn't gentle, she looked rat ass, you know, because she was out.
She'd have one of them nights, hadn't she?
Yeah. So. But I want one of them nights, but hey.
So, Kate, you've got a few things there you'd like to tell us about.
I have.
These guys.
I've been doing some digging on things local to the area, and I've got some pretty interesting things. So what I'm going to tell you tonight is about a local girl who's done really well for herself. This is the, you know, the perfect story of local girl has made it. It's about someone, and if you haven't heard of her, where have you been? She's called Yvette Royal. She is a fantastic singer. Basically, heard my notes, so bear with me. She's an international professional singer and actress who lives in the Altrincham and Hale area. She's worked with some really famous stars at professional events all over the world. I'm going to read out a few of these because they're just amazing what she's done. She has worked for Umbro in Kuala Lumpur at the Malaysian World Cup. She's basically supported Tony Hadley. She's she does the Miss Manchester competition all the time. She's done it 3 years running, including this year. The Lord of Mayor Manchester Ball. She's done Dawn Ward's Real Housewives of Cheshire, Creme de la Creme Ball. Worked with Alexandra O'Neill, Alicia Dixon, the Jersey Boys, just so many. Recently she did Denise Welsh's Gem Appeal Ball as well, which is annual. She's due to release a track actually. She's doing a cover of Run, and that's going to be released on the 30th of November 2017. And she has just duetted with the X Factor finalist. I think he's a finalist, I don't watch X Factor personally. But Michael Rice on cover of Beneath Your Beautiful. I am going to put the link up to Yvette. She's a fantastic singer and performer. Take a look at her, she's amazing. The reason why I'm mentioning Yvette is that she does a huge amount of charity for CAFT, which is the Children's Adventure Farm Trust. Have you heard of CAFT? It's based in Millington, it's near Dunham and Lynn. She's done four huge charity nights so far, raising money for this wonderful organisation. And she puts live music on, which she sings at. She has supporting artists. I've actually got these on my phone as well. Let me just see who her supporting artists are. They are local to the area. One's called Ewan Sim, and the other one is Kenny Guthrie, who I've actually seen live. He's great. She's going to be doing another one of these charity gigs, and I've had the pleasure of attending the second one she did, which was absolutely incredible. It's just such a good party night, live music, you get a sprinkling of celebs going as well from Real Housewives of Cheshire. Simon Gregson, who plays Steve McDonald, I think it is, that's on Corrie.
Yeah,
he goes all the time with his wife, beautiful wife Emma as well. You get Kim Marsh going down. You get the paparazzi out and everything, so it's a proper little celeb event, but it's great. The next one is going to be on Saturday the 3rd of February. Now, if you are interested in going to this, we are covering this event. So I'm really proud to say that. We're going to go down, it's going to be a really dressed up night, but we're going to do a covering of Yvette for you. The tickets are £20 each. Now, this is at Bowden RUFC on Clay Lane. If you want tickets and supper, it's £30. The food's actually really good as well if you want to go. There's live performances, there's raffles in aid of the CAFT. Some of the prizes are great, you know, trips abroad and everything. I've seen some of these raffle prizes, my jaw dropped what people donate. It is a fun-packed night with great music. So we are going to cover this. I'm also quite pleased to say I'm going to get an exclusive interview with Yvette as well in the next coming weeks about her life in music and TV. And I can tell you exclusively that on Tuesday she's going to be filming a short film. Now this is quite dark, this film. It's about a mother who discovers her daughter after she commits suicide. It's really emotional, dark. Yvette is a brilliant actress. This is going to be played so well. She plays the main character, Sheila, as well. So I'm going to post all these links on the Autumn News website, so you can just look at Yvette, you can just check her website out. She is going to have a piece done on her as well in the Manchester Evening News, so look out for that. But yeah, that's my news, and that's our event that we're going to cover there. You have to see Yvette to believe Yvette. Once you've met her, you will never forget her. She's that good. So, yeah.
Brilliant.
You brought a whole lot of motivation with you,
haven't
you? Proper keen you are, Kate.
I've got to say, she's just won Come Dine With Me as well. So, do we have any Come Dine With Me fans here?
I'm sure there are.
Yeah, she was on about 3-4 weeks ago, Yvette Royal, the blonde one, very glamorous. So if you watch that, let us know, and you might know who she is.
Yeah, so watch out on the page. We'll be posting links to all that. Also coming up, we've been talking about a bit of a competition this evening and all. We're going to be offering a couple of tickets for a show called Warhorse at the Liverpool Empire on Thursday 16th of November. Now, if you're interested, you can watch out on the page for that. We're going to dream up some sort of little competition for you guys. For these, how many tickets was it? Was it
two? Tickets.
Two tickets to Warhorse at the Liverpool Empire. Thursday 16th of November, you must be able to get yourself down to Liverpool for that at 7:30. And we're just going to have a little think about what sort of competition we're going to do for that. So watch out for that, that's coming up on the page. It'll have to be soon, won't it?
Because that's a couple of weeks off, I think.
It's coming up, so we'll get on with that next week and we'll post something on the page early this week for you guys to have a go at. We're thinking some sort of draw where we'll draw names out live on a live stream, but just watch out for that and see what's what.
Yeah.
Hey.
It's a good show. It's been touring for 8 years, so it's actually it's a touring company now, going all over the world doing this. So apparently it's phenomenal, the show. Really good. Has anyone ever seen Warhorse? Have you ever been to see it at all? Can anyone just comment? Tell us what you thought about it.
Yeah. Chris Aki-Atkinson, it's one of our regulars, Chris. Hi, Chris. He's always there. Saying, typical man. Typical blokey thing. He's like, hiya, love. So say hi to Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Yeah, Chris called me on my Wednesday when I did a live. It wasn't Wednesday, was it?
Tuesday.
It was Tuesday. I did an extra one for World Mental Health Day. I was on the phone with Chris there for about 30 minutes.
Mm.
So, yeah, Chris, as we said on the phone, we've now put a voice to the name. We've tried a couple of times to put a face to the name, but every time we've arranged to meet you, something's come up and somebody's had to cancel, so we will get around to that. Dave says, how does this work? Dave says, I was just in Altrincham, hi from Canada. How did you manage that? How did you get back to Canada from just being in Altrincham? Or do you mean last week or something? Sorry, did that go over everybody's head?
I was just trying to figure out how... Maybe he is in Canada at the moment. Are you in Canada?
Hi, anyway, if
you're in Canada.
I assume it's okay. Yeah. Your friend Daniel Pinkerton. He'd like to shout out.
Hi Daniel, all right mate, how are you?
Or a woohoo.
No.
Have I embarrassed you about doing your woohoo?
I can do him all night.
Oh wait, it says up to you. So go on, give him a proper Chris woohoo.
Woohoo!
Right, happy with that, Daniel?
I love this girl already.
So, guys, please keep joining in. You can join in. Will you behave yourself?
Shut your face.
You're getting all giddy now, aren't you?
No, I'm
giddy. You can join in on these comments. Or if you'd like to speak to any of us, you can give us a call 07874055611. Joe's got one of them and all. Come on, Joe, let's hear
you're
it.
You're dying not to laugh behind that camera.
Let's hear it.
Do it!
No, that was
that's what I feel like.
What are you doing? Right, okay. I think we ought to leave the songs back if they don't quite work, do they? So,
well, yeah.
So, yeah, we will... that competition, we'll put a link on the page tonight with some information what this Warhorse show is actually about. So, have a look, and if you're interested, take part in our competition.
Mm. Yes, it's going to be quite a big one. So please tell your friends to like our page and get in there.
Yeah. Also, like our Instagram page. We've just gone on Instagram since Monday or Tuesday,
Monday.
Was it?
Yes.
So, yeah, we've got an Instagram page. You'll find us, Altrincham News. Take a look. Like us. We might like you back.
Yeah.
Tracy, write your contact details on the whiteboard behind you.
It's not a whiteboard, this is our screen.
Yeah, that doesn't actually do anything other than it was just somewhere to put it when we moved in the studio, but it works, doesn't it?
It is black on the other side.
So, yeah, we need some, yeah, maybe the phone number behind us. If you want that number, 07874055611, call in.
Write it on there.
Welcome, say. Yeah, welcome our new member, Kate. Yeah, say hello to her. I will. I'll do as I'm told. I will tap that number in the comments here so you guys can see it. So, being a bloke, this will probably take me about 20 minutes. So I'll be back forthwith.
Yeah. So Kate, what are you doing this week?
What am I doing?
Yeah, well we've got over 20 minutes.
Same stuff, different week for me. So working, teaching. What am I doing? It's Monday tomorrow.
Yay, another Monday!
Yeah, I have Mondays off.
So do I. No, I'm
which is
day.
Really good. I'm so glad I have Mondays off. But yeah, back to work. Back teaching. Woohoo! Yeah, that's it really for me.
There we go. Phone number's down there now, guys. Give us a call. 07874055611. Double one.
Before you do that,
woohoo!
I'm actually really interested to hear people's thoughts on Altrincham because a lot of the moment we've got a lot of shops closing down. I've just noticed opposite Bistro Pierre, the Greenwood, so that's closing down at the moment. What do people think should go into Altrincham?
Starbucks.
Well, we've got one at
Altrincham. Yeah, it's the same because it's too small.
But. Well, how big do you want it?
Oh,
you need coffee.
I love Starbucks. It's one of my favourite coffee shops in the world.
I mean,
except Granty's.
Yeah, that's actually a really good one, Granty's. And Sweet Octopus. I have to shout out Sweet Octopus. Brilliant Japanese patisserie. Ladies, it's only half the fat and half the sugar that they use in all the cakes, so amazing cakes. And gents as well, if you're concerned about that. But yeah, I'd be interested to know what people are wanting in Altrincham. I know we can't actually choose what we want, but what would you like in there? I know I'd like a really good shoe shop.
Yeah, there's Jake's moving into
Jake's.
Where's
Jake's?
A shoe shop.
Is it a shoe shop?
It's a mix. Yeah, it's top and bottom. No, it's mixed.
Didn't they used to have like a Dulcie's years ago
long
in Altrincham?
Back,
yeah, I remember going there and getting shoes from there, and I loved it, and then they closed it down and...
Yeah, Timpsons.
Timpsons.
Oh, that was one of my favourites when I was a school kid. My mum used to take me to get some shoes. It used to take me 2 hours to choose a pair of shoes.
2 hours?
Yes.
Oh
school
my God,
shoes.
I'm just an in and out girl. I can't be doing with shopping anymore. It's like I go in, spend 10 minutes at the Babble Do. Out.
Oh God.
I did
terrible.
Actually buy some walking boots from Millets the other day. I'm going away with Mr. B on 3rd of November and we're going climbing up and down hills.
Oh, lovely.
Great. So, yeah, really looking forward to that. But, yeah, I'd just like to see some different shops in there, really. I'd like to see something completely different that we've never had. You know, at one time people were saying Primark had come to Altrincham. It would be where the old
CNA
and New Year.
Yeah. Now it's going to be Flannels, God.
Flannels? Is that the guy's shop? The suit shop? Or?
Yeah, it's a mixed shop, I think.
I'm sure they had Flannels in Altrincham at some point somewhere.
I think they did way, way back.
Yeah.
Maybe before your time, Chris, because you're another baby of the team, aren't you?
I am. Which is good, actually. I get things done.
Chris, how old are you?
What?
How old are you?
Me?
Yeah.
Have a guess.
in your 20s.
Oh, I wish!
He's gonna love you!
I love you now.
30 on your own, baby.
Yeah, I'm 32 in November, the day you go away.
Yeah.
Chris Aki is asking if your jacket's extra large. Wait, are you looking particularly baggy?
Well, no, I've lost a bit of weight.
And he says he wants one, because he's already got the t-shirt.
Well...
I hope you're looking after that t-shirt, Chris.
Yeah, well, we might bring out a few new things.
Could give one away in a competition.
Yeah, Chris got our t-shirts
after
last year's Children in Need event. He donated £50 for one of our t-shirts.
Oh, really?
Children in Need, so...
Oh, that's great. That's really good, actually.
That was
well
fantastic.
Done.
Yeah, I think all the team needs to wear a uniform on our live nights.
I'll wear a badge.
Well, we can do that then.
Yeah.
We can make you a badge.
I'd like a mug saying Altrincham News or
yeah.
I Love Altrincham.
Oh, yes.
The clock on one side, one hashtag Altrincham on the back.
Yeah.
That would work.
Or hashtag woohoo.
Yes!
No,
yes.
No,
sorry, I won't fuel
that. No, they will sell actually. We get too many people woohooing at me. It's annoying. It's annoying, but I love it.
Okay. An interesting comment here.
Come on.
It says, ask Kate about the ice rink.
Do you know the ice?
Who's it from?
That's from Jill Madden.
Altrincham ice rink. Wait, what do you know on me that I've told you when I've had a few drinks?
Ah, I see.
Do you want to phone in, Auntie Jill? What's the number?
The number is 07874055611. It's just up there in the comment. No, it's not up there. Down there, but up a little bit in the comments. If you scroll around, you'll find it. 07874055611. Please let us know. And give us the inside info on the new girl.
New girl. She's not a new girl.
Please don't. Oh, no. I just can't remember what I've told her. Oh, no. don't, because I think the in-laws are watching. I don't want to be in trouble.
I commented the name Sam.
No.
My cousin Emily, at the time, was seeing Sambo, I like to call him. Sam's lovely. We all went to Altrincham Ice Rink a couple of years ago. It was the new one. Thank God you're not talking about the old one here. There's a few stories there.
Me and all.
But we basically were kind of just pushing each other over on the ice constantly. I did my ice skating awards at the old ice rink, funnily enough. Just strengthening my ankles. I had really weak ankles as a child. Anyway, we went on the ice for Christmas, and I have never seen someone skate like Bambi before. It was like watching a spider put ice skates on every single limb, just trying to get across the ice. So what I was doing was collecting all the ice and just throwing it in his face and all sorts. And yeah, he thinks he got me, he didn't, so I just got him. But I think it's one of those, you'd have to be there to see it, but my Auntie Jill, all he could hear was a cackling behind going, go on, get him, pass him in the head. Poor Sam.
It's a long time since I've been on a pair of blades, but I used to be down at that one in Bloodheath every Saturday afternoon.
Oh, that was amazing, the old ice rink.
It was great, wasn't it?
It was brilliant. I had quite a few teachers from there. The one that I remember was the very small blonde woman. I can't remember her name at all, but she was amazing. And they were all like ex-Olympic skaters. He used to teach us, they were fantastic. And do you remember the old pull down screen we had? We used to play the music videos, they had the DJ in the box.
Yeah.
Used to go up and say, oh, can I have Yaz playing or something? And
sure,
everyone would try
to. No.
Yeah, you'd skate around as fast as you could, but now it's so different.
I've been in this new one once.
It's good.
That was to cover, we were doing a bit of a live stream on a hockey match.
Yeah.
I need to get back on it. We said we were going to do that. We were trying to organise a Valentine's event last year, weren't we? But we just didn't have time to.
What,
play
on love on the ice?
Well,
on
ice. there was a bit of tipsy going on around that.
There was
time.
A lot of tipsy going on around that time. But that's sort of back there now.
Yeah, it's in the bin.
We've moved on. Mm. Just going back to what we were saying before, you were asking what shops people would like to see in Altrincham. Mm. Tracy Jones would like to see baby shops because apparently she struggled to buy a baby mattress last week.
Oh, really?
Well, Argos is just open in Sainsbury's, so that's just a walk.
Yeah. I remember they used to have Mothercare on the corner where the card shop was.
Oh yes, where Car Factory used to be.
And they used to have this Bambino as well that used to be next to Jose's. It's on the road that's opposite the Orange Tree or the Market Tavern. Yeah, there really isn't much, is there? You've got to go into Hale to find baby items. Yeah. And, you know, you get shops like Pixie who do beautiful items, but where do you get your baby? Oh, I don't have children actually, so I wouldn't have a clue to be honest. But yeah, where would you get a baby mattress from?
Yes, Mothercare still on the retail park.
Yeah.
Well, they have, Mothercare on the retail park, but not directly in Altrincham.
No, you probably have to go to Argos for that or something, you know.
Yeah.
Have you got to think about Argos at the minute?
Yeah, because Argos is moving into Sainsbury's and I work for Sainsbury's.
How much are you getting paid for this?
Don't matter. It's just all going on with everything, with all these refits that's going on to put them in.
Mm-hmm. Okay, talking about things that are going on, we mentioned just before about Chris Aki-Atkinson who donated 50 whole quid at our Children in Need event. We've been talking about another event coming up, haven't we? And I'm quite keen on this one, so I'd like to talk to you guys about that a little bit more. Market Dave, what do we make of Market Dave then?
Hey. He's brilliant. I'm going to tell you my first memory of Market Dave. My parents were late picking me up. I'd just come out of Loretto and he actually sat with me and waited with me while my parents were coming. So yeah, he was like my hero growing up. I always used to say hello to him. His name isn't Market Dave. I'm not going to tell you what his real name is. But what a character. And he's such a love character as well. So I think your idea, Andy, is... say too much. I'm going to let you say what you think is appropriate.
Well, we put a little something on the page last night. Back in May, I mentioned this on Wednesday, back in May, we, within a space of about 3 days, we, with a little help, we managed to put together that memorial. Do you remember that one, Chris? That was fantastic. Yes. Very popular, at least a couple of hundred people turned up, and I'm so proud to have been involved in that. And make that happen. And it only happened because Altrincham was behind it and we got your guys' support. So we'd like to draw on that Altrincham support again and make a Market Dave themed charity event happen as we head into the winter. We're still looking at ideas, but we're thinking some kind of race with flat caps, maybe pushing homemade handcarts of some sort. Kate has spoken to a few people who need speaking to regarding this and they've given us our blessing to go ahead with it. So there's nothing stopping us, guys. We're just looking for your ideas. Would you be interested in putting a team in? Should we make it a single person event or is it going to be a team event? Any ideas why you'd like to see it held? We'd like to make this happen. The charity we would like to be nominated by Dave's family, or there are alternatives. Perhaps we could spread the proceeds. I was thinking maybe spread the proceeds around the established charity shops in Altrincham because one or two of the charity shops in Altrincham have been there as long as I can remember.
Yeah.
So maybe something that benefits the whole of Altrincham. But maybe Dave's family has their own ideas. I mean, guys, come at us with your ideas. We can only make this happen with your help and we'd love to see it happen. So get in touch with us and tell us your thoughts about that one. Please.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, that's my little baby at the moment, yeah. I'm really liking that. I'm going to get stuck into that one.
That sounds good.
Okay. Is that the real name, Market Dave? No, when no. I
His surname's O'Keefe. I don't want to say his first name just in case it's wrong, but I know the family's surname is O'Keefe.
Yeah, I'm the same. I've got a name in my head.
Yeah.
But I can't remember if that's right. Yeah. But he's Market Day, isn't he?
Yeah. Do you remember the beautiful paintings of him a few years ago?
Yeah.
Absolutely stunning, those paintings. They had like just a face kind of profile portrait painting of him that was absolutely gorgeous. Joanne, you'll know which, I mean, they were stunning, weren't they? And one of them like dragging the handcart as well. Beautiful. They were gorgeous.
I remember when I was younger, Dave used to have two hand carts.
Two, yeah.
He used to push one down the road, then go back and get the second one, push that right further on, then come back and get his hand cart. Two of them he used to leapfrog all the way into Altrincham and back.
Oh my gosh.
But bless him, as he got older, he went down to one.
Oh, yeah, but even one for a lot of people, really? I mean...
Yeah. Either come rain or shine, the guy was out.
Yeah.
He was a hard worker.
Yeah, proper grafter.
Will always be remembered by Altrincham.
So you're right.
He's definitely a legend. I mean, I was thinking about the people around Altrincham, you know, who really stand out to people. I think the only other person who's in the Strandon area would probably be Frank Sidebottom in Timperley.
Yeah.
Who stand out. I mean, he's just, everyone knows him. They're just these characters that people love. Can anyone else think of any characters who just stand out in Altrincham to you? I mean, I don't know, there's certain things about Altrincham that are quite nostalgic to me. It's like the Loretto Girls blazer. We always used to get called the deck chairs.
Oh, but yeah.
It's the one that we used to think of. Because, yeah, they weren't the nicest, but yeah, we always used to get the Mickey taken out of us. And then the Alty Boys one, we always used to call the Kermits. But yeah, bright green. I think they still are as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, they are.
Bless you. I think it's something you've got to put up with while you're growing up. But yeah, those are the things that stand out to me. I'm just wondering what everyone else's memories are. You've got the ice rink, like the old ice rink that's iconic, the Altrincham clock, but what about people?
I can't think of anybody else. I know there was some old dear in the bus station who was known as Queenie.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't know what happened to her, but yeah, not a lot of people seem to know about her. I think she came and went. And
can I just verify something? Am I having the mickey taken out of my hair? Is Timperley Rhubarb famous?
Yes.
Wait, is it?
Is it? That's new to me.
Yeah, I didn't realise. I thought someone was winding me up saying, no. I've never heard of that in my life. Timperley Rhubarb.
Yeah, it's true.
Actual rhubarb.
Yeah.
Okay.
Rhubarb. Okay, alright.
Yeah.
I don't like rhubarb, so I'm not going to try it. But yeah, someone was saying to me, it's one of the most famous things in the area. I'm like, really? But yeah, apparently so. It's been confirmed by Chris, so...
I've lived here for years and I've never heard of that.
I've never heard of Timperley Rhubarb. Never. We did have Roy Keane, who lived around the area for absolutely ages. Always used to go in the Stamford Arms or the Griffin. And that's it, that's all I can think of. And then the footballers, but we need some more local characters.
Thomas Graham is suggesting the Scoutman as another Altrincham character.
Can you give us some more information on that?
Who's the Scoutman, Thomas? We're not sure who you're talking about there. I'm imagining it's some sort of scout leader who's done a lot for...
Yeah, I hope it's something not dodgy, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let us know. We'd be interested to see who that is.
Yeah, if anyone else has any people that really stand out to them, we'd be interested to know.
So, yeah, Market Day charity event this winter. Watch out for the details on that. If you can... Any ideas or any help you can give us on that, please get in touch. Thank you.
Yes.
Hand up, your turn. No, he just went for our trail to go past. It's in our soundproof studio.
Is that actually going over the head?
No, it's just going over.
See, I can feel it coming through the walls. It's like a massage chair.
Oh, yeah, that's your side of the chair now, like that.
I feel it.
You'd be surprised.
Apparently, it's haunted in here as well.
We don't want to know that, Andy.
No. Oh no, not on the sofa! Oh.
I'm going to be bringing my wet wipes in next time.
Yeah, you better. You better.
This sofa used to live in my living room.
Oh.
But it had legs then.
What happened to the legs?
You don't want to.
Little question about them. They're hiring them.
Yeah, they're being preserved for Altrincham heritage, aren't they?
Great.
That's what we're doing with them. No, we could do with that. Yeah, we could do with being lifted a little higher.
You're like, you.
I quite like being sunk in here. It's like. It's quite comfy.
I'll pull you out when you finish.
I'm like, yeah.
Okay, so we've still no idea who the scout man is. Huh? Who is the scout man? If you'd like to call and tell us, we'll give it just another shot because we're going to be running out of time shortly. We don't want to bore you to death too long. 07874055611. Who's vibrating? Somebody
I thought I heard someone out there.
You more than likely
like
did.
If I see a face at that window, I'm
just coming out. It's one of those windows, isn't it, where it can just appear out of the darkness.
Very, very easily. Like, very easily. I was saying before, I don't do horror and all that.
Don't scare.
Don't
woo-hoo
me,
because... Mummy! Mummy! Where have we got baby down? They just leave me alone and woo-hoo! Edo?
No.
Bea, can you see what professional team you joined?
Oh yeah, don't mind.
I tell you what, when I worked at ICM, they had nothing on you guys. Seriously.
Yeah.
You need to give them training. I didn't really work at ICM on, so. but yeah.
So, I think we're going to be wrapping up now, aren't we?
Yeah.
45 minutes is more than we normally bore you with on a Sunday evening.
But a lot of things will change for the next few weeks, won't they, Andy?
Yeah, as you heard earlier on from... You know what, I'm going to forget your name then. Yeah, interviews, reviews and things all coming your way as we head into our autumn season. Because we're all professional now, we have shows and seasons.
Oh yes, you do, yes.
You've got to think positive.
But they start on Monday the 6th of November, after I've been away.
Yeah, so your next breakfast show, well done with your breakfast show, by the way. Did you enjoy that?
Oh, it was quite emotional, but yes, I did well.
How did you find it? Were you scared doing it?
I wasn't, I thought to myself, how can I go about it? But the day before that was the 5th anniversary when I lost my mum.
I saw that actually, that was pretty emotional to me.
Yeah,
so.
And I thought I need to do something for it and talk about Altrincham and etc. But I did alright.
Yeah.
You know, and I thought, let's do a little bit.
I'm looking forward to see what you've got planned for your next one, so.
Yeah, I might do a live show in Cornwall. I'm going to Cornwall next Wednesday with Joe. And we might do one there, I guess. We'll see what happens. But Andy will do his Wednesdays.
Is anyone having like Cornish cream tea?
Oh,
those Cornish cream teas.
I love them. Mm. What's first then, the cream or the jam?
I do mine. I have butter on, and then I try and make it look really neat. I put the cream, then the jam on.
Oh, that's the Devon way.
Oh, is that wrong?
Yeah. Cornwall's the other way around.
Oh no, is it like Man United, Man City?
Yeah, it is.
Sorry if you want
no,
to.
No, you're fine.
We'll just return to the comments for a minute. Vicky Thompson says that she remembers Queenie. Well, she thinks that she lived near the Bonin River. She was seen around the bus station quite a lot. Chris Atkinson, again. Ask about your walkabouts, Chris.
My walkabouts, tell you what, I might do one before I go away, but I'll try and fit it in. I am busy on Tuesday, but I get the coach on Wednesday morning. But I might try and fit one in, or I'll try and do one to get back.
Chris suggested last week that we do a trip down Atlantic Street. North East, because I think that's a big part of Altrincham, isn't it? A lot of people work down there, and you know, places like Budenberg's with a bit of history. I'm sure people would be interested to see how things have changed down there.
Is
so.
The Carl Nash building being sold? Is she selling that to someone?
I'm not sure. I know the business itself has been sold, hasn't it?
I read that in the paper the other day. I just can't remember the complete details.
So, yeah, we'll organise that. A video up and down Atlantic Street. Maybe that's something you'd like to do as a walk. If not, I'll tell Chris it'll happen anyway. Maybe something I can get onto while you're away.
You two guys do it.
I like
walking,
so.
Alright, we'll make that happen sometime
in the
next week. So.
Yeah, why not?
He'll steal the show. Okay.
What sort of dog you got?
What's his face?
I might steal a dog.
Borrow a dog.
I might steal Mr. B's dog. He's a gorgeous white Siberian husky.
Oh,
he's lovely.
We'll have to bring him in.
My two dogs. Seriously, he wouldn't. He'd howl. He'd get on the sofa and he wouldn't let you on.
That's good. That'd be alright. That'd be your handy there. Then.
And
I'm done.
Yeah, we've got a new Andy coming.
Could never replace Andy.
you
can have mini me Andy though.
Because
you both wear it, you're wearing white. You can have the dog white.
I've got my buddy Eric over there.
I've got
you're
a little
dog
called
Max.
Yet,
well, we're not talking about that's Andy's sock. Yeah.
Have you heard what he's calling you?
Is it really a sock?
No, it's a muppet.
A muppet? What? A muppet?
No, leave him if he's not allowed out.
That guy was my partner on the radio for...
I bet he was.
Years. Don't ask me how a mute puppet worked on the radio, but he did join me.
That would be interesting to try, actually. Which radio station did you used to work for?
I was around a few in the 80s, Piccadilly.
Key 103? That one or...
Before that?
Yeah.
Yeah, before we were actually Key 103.
When did they change to Key 103?
I can't remember exactly, but they split frequencies and then had different programming.
I remember it being called Piccadilly Key 103 at one point. I remember the jingle to it as well, and I'm not going to do it, but... Ages ago, I used to watch it and I used to listen to it in the 90s.
I'm talking back in the days when it was Piccadilly 261.
Wow.
On your wavelength. That's what the window stickers used to say.
Yeah.
I had a pirate radio and all, that was fun. So, yeah, Eric has a little bit of a history.
We have our own radio station, don't we? On Radio Rushing Well at Trafford General. You can come to the next one.
Can I come to it?
Yeah. You can come see our internet mate.
Okay.
He's lovely. I've worked with him in Sainsbury's, he does the card section and he loves what I do, so I introduced him to Andy and them two, they just don't get on with each other.
Oh.
Do you, Andy, because they're all bantering
about.
I
will smooth the waters.
Yeah, just get
I'm a good diplomat. For the next show, I'm going to be telling you a bit more about other interviews that I'm going to be doing with people around the local area. I've got quite a few more lined up, to be honest, so I'm not going to give you everything today, but again, just look out for the link for Yvette Royal. I will post those up actually this evening. You can click onto them, see what she's about, listen to her songs. You can get a preview of Run as well, the one that Leona Lewis did, and also Snow Patrol. Fantastic voice. That's all I can say. And again, if you wish to come to the next gig, which will be the fifth gig for CAFT, Children's Adventure Farm Trust, you can get tickets for that. I will be posting the link for all this. So, thanks for listening to me, guys.
Yeah. Can I just say, hi, Joe. Joe Cushing has joined us. Joe, if you rewind this video at the beginning, I think you'll find a few things that might interest you that Kate was telling us about at the top there. So,
Joe, by the way.
Joe Cushing. Oh, Joe, I need a word with you. I'll message you later. Just the little thing that's giving them a curve.
Okay. So... I think we're pretty much done for tonight.
Yeah, I guess.
So, Kate. thank you for being here and joining the team.
You're very welcome. Thank you for having me.
Breath of fresh air.
And thanks for listening to me, guys. Really appreciate it. You've had no choice, but thank you anyway.
Yeah, now you stop with that. Woohoo!
So, yeah, I will see you guys this Wednesday, 8:30, as usual. Chris, you will be around when next?
I'll have a few days. I'll have a word with Joe about what we can do.
Yeah, we're playing around with this split screen thing through the week, so we might have a go at something like that while Chris is gallivanting down there in Cornwall.
Yay.
But other than that, I think we're done for this evening.
Yes. So, Altrincham, thank you very much, and we'll see you all very soon. So.